Hello, this is Travis Sabin with Adobe Analytics Product Management. And in this video, I'm going to be walking you through the folders capabilities within Analysis Workspace. So with folders, here on the Workspace landing page, there are two types of folders. There's a company folder, and then all other folders are personal folders. The company folder is a folder that is automatically created for every single member of your organization. It's distinguished from the other folders with this little person avatar on it because this folder is automatically shared with all users within this organization. There's no restrictions or limitations that you can put on the company folder or any of its contents. Within the company folder, you can add subfolders to group them. So in this case, I have got my marketing folder where I could put a bunch of reports and projects for my marketing team. You could do the same thing for a bunch of other organizations. The other type of folder is a personal folder. And personal folders are just that. They are only created for your personal view. They are not shareable or accessible by anyone else. They are only visible on your instance of Analysis Workspace and are curated based on whatever creation you do for organizing them. Now, a couple of differences. The company folder, only admins can add or create content in the company folder. So they could create subfolders, they can move projects in or out, they can save projects to the company folder, but they cannot share or restrict any of the folders or subfolders within the company folder, and they cannot govern or control any of your personal folders. However, let's say that a user creates a project and they share it with an admin and the admin thinks it's worthy of sharing with the broader team and so they want to add it to the company folder. When they do that, it will get removed from the personal location that it was saved for that original owner and will be added to the company folder. If that project was shared with specific individuals, they will still have access to it, but as will anyone else in the organization. But let's say that an admin decides one day we don't need it anymore and they move it out of the company folder. The people that it was originally shared with would still have access to that project. However, it will not be returned to its previously stored location on anyone's personal folder list or anything like that. It would automatically just come back to the default screen here on the project list. So that is a little bit more about the company folder. Now, to create a folder, you simply come up and click on this new Create Folder button, and you give it a name, and let's say Recording Folder. And now automatically it's added to your page. So now within this folder, if I wanted to, I can create subfolders. To create a subfolder, you just click on the Create Folder button. This is a fairly empty folder other than the subfolder I just created. So there's a couple of ways that I can add content to this folder itself. I can move entire folders into another folder, or I can add a single project or multiple projects into the subfolder. So I can select this entire folder and I could move it to my recording folder. And now in my recording folder, I have this testing folder with some content within there. I can also do the same thing with projects. So I can click on a project. I can do multiple projects if I want to. And I can use the action bar here or on the ellipses to move to. And then I get this modal and I make a selection and I move it to my recording folder. Another option is once I'm within the company folder, we have these ellipses here up at the top next to the Create Folder button. I can do a couple of things with this. I can use this to add projects. I can rename this folder if I don't like the name anymore. I can move this entire folder and I could delete this entire folder. If I delete any folders, all of the folder contents are retained. They are not deleted. They will just go up one level in a hierarchy. So essentially that means the quick segments demo and these two folders would then go to the projects page. If I had another folder before it, it would go to that folder before going to the projects page. So it just moves up one level in a hierarchy, but no content is actually deleted, just the folder itself. So if I want to add a project to this screen, I can click Add Projects, and now I get a list of all of my projects. I can select what I want, and I add it. And now it's here, visible within this folder. To go back, I simply click on the project's name up here at the top, and that helps me navigate back. Now, any of the folders, whether they're company or personal, have a few limitations. You can only go 10 levels deep, just for storage capacity purposes. but you can add as many subfolders within that as you want, as long as you're within that 10 folder limit. So you can go all the way down to 10, and I've set this up ahead of time, so it's there. Once I get into 10 though, the create folder button is gone because I can't add any more subfolders. I can only add projects to this list. I can't add any more. And once I've gone more than two levels deep here, the navigation up here changes at the top. I can see the immediate folder before that I can click on to navigate to if I want to, or I can click on this little folder with a little caret that shows me my entire hierarchy from my root folder, the projects, all the way down to this 10th folder that I am in. And if I want to go somewhere else, I can just click on that. And now I can navigate away to that other screen. A couple of other things here on the landing page, the default view is here to show folders and projects together and however you have organized them. But if for some reason you wanted to view just a list of all of your projects, then we have an option here to show and choose from this dropdown either folders and projects, which is the default, or you can go to the all projects view. This is essentially how the landing page was previous to folders existing. It's just a running list of all of your projects that you have within Analysis Workspace. So last thing I want to show is once I've, let's say I've created a new project that I've been working on and I want to save it. When you go to save the project, there's a new option within the save modal. There's a folder drop down within the save modal. So if you don't select one, it will automatically go to the root folder. But if I wanted to save it somewhere, let's say I want to go in my recording folder, then I can say recording demo project. And then I save it. And now if I go back to my landing page, I click open my recording folder, and now I've got my recording demo project saved there right away. So some really great functionality here to help with your organization of your projects and help you hopefully find what you're looking for a little bit easier when you come back to Analysis Workspace. Thank you for your time.